Celis. Well, I'm going to tell you guys about my software engineering internship at Crane Aerospace and Electronics. And so first of all, what I'm going to go over today is just tell you a little bit about Crane, because I'm pretty sure not many of you know about them, and the project itself that I was a part of, and my specific task within that project, and the results of my internship. So a little bit about Crane. They provide many solutions to many aircraft manufacturers, and these can be people like Boeing, Airbus, and COMAC, which is a Chinese manufacturer. And they provide things like sensing and utility systems, fluid management, power solutions, landing and cabin systems, as well as microwave solutions. And most of the development that they do there is embedded systems. They don't really do many software things. So a little about the project that I was a part of. It was a door signal system for the COMAC C919. And it's part of the sensing system department. And not to get too technical, but just so you can understand what my task was, there's two hardware cards in the system. And they both basically run the door signal system. And for me, I was to implement the inter-board communication component, and I'll get into that into a set. And then the other one was to update the serial communication interface documentation in my downtime. And I'm not going to get to talk about that one today, but the documentation process follows basically the same as the one for the inter-board communication. So basically what my component is it gathers data from external software components, and it encodes the data for transfer, and transfers it via the SCI software to hardware interface. And then what it also does is grabs data from there, decode it, and make it available for other people to use. I am really not concerned what the data is or what it's going to be used for, but it's mainly to make sure that the two cars are receiving the same data from the sensors, and if there's a discrepancy, that there'd be like an issue going on and we could diagnose it. And so the first part of this project was to do the design. I did it in IBM Rational Doors. And basically what I have to do is go through each function and list its purpose, limitations and assumptions, its inputs and outputs, and the function calls, as well as low-level requirements, which I think that was the biggest part of doing the documentation. Basically what a low-level requirement is mapping it from a high-level requirement to a low-level one, one or more. Or you create low-level requirements, which are UMARC as derived, and those are ones that show up at this process of design. And so after that, I just moved from design into implementation. I implemented in C, in Eclipse, and it's just a staggered view of all the code that I wrote that does basically what I just described to you guys. And so the various tools that I use Eclipse to implement the project, and Waterbot or Trace32, I'm gonna get to that one in a sec, I think is the most important one that I've used. And then I also used the IBM Rational Suite, and that's Rational Change, which was for the change control process where I submitted my papers and got it approved or had changes to it. And then I also, IBM Rational Synergy was for resource control. And the last tool down here is LDRA, it's a test bed for static and dynamic analysis of our code. And so what Waterbot Trace32 is it allows me to run and debug my code, because in an embedded systems environment, what I learned is you can't really run the code in Eclipse. You have to run it on the actual hardware. And this tool would allow me to do that. I would have to go to the hardware lab and connect the two hardware cards that we were using to these probes. And then I would go back to my desk and I'd have a setup like this. And on the bottom, that's the actual Trace32 application. And then I would get my code pop up there, and I could put breakpoints and step through it, and then I'd always have to watch memory and certain data structures to see if the data was being sent and processed correctly and decoded. So for the results of my internship, I was told that my code will fly on the COMAC C919 when it is certified. And will I be going back to Crane? I'm not guaranteed right now. They don't usually extend offers to their interns. I'm recommended to go back, but I just have to apply again. And for me, I think I would love to go back just because of, like, I think what they do is meaningful. It's cool to say that I worked on an airplane. And the environment there was really good. They're very supportive and they're fun to be around. But I kind of disliked all the documentation that goes, but it's because of like the aerospace nature of it and the waterfall. There's a ton of documentation and embedded systems in general. I don't really know if that's my thing. And so what I learned about how software engineering and aerospace go hand in hand. Applying to this position, I didn't really know what a company like Crane wanted a software engineer for, but I saw they needed a CS degree, so I just decided to apply. But I did learn that they usually do it through embedded systems and real-time systems. I also learned the C programming language, the waterfall SDLC, the peer review process, that's what I have to go through for my documentation, the change control process, which I also have to do for my documentation, and various communication skills, as well as software engineering tools that are used in the workplace. And a lot of the courses that I took in this major really did help. 3.6 to C wasn't that bad. It would have been much harder to go from Java to C. And then I also found that this internship helped me for the current class that I was taking, the 430. I realized that an embedded system is basically like an operating system without user interface.